What a day on the bench. We have this DeWalt 20-volt max blower. We have a battery that has two bars here, so the battery is known to be good. No output at all from the blower. I've already taken 7 of the screws out of this side because this side looks more like the impeller side, and this handle side here looks like where the speed control would be to me. So just like that, we're in. And one cool thing about this older technology, this is going to be just a brushed DC motor. Because even with a power supply or a battery, we could actually test the motor independently of the speed control. So we do have a slide here. Well, that's actually a little... Oh, it even says on that 100%, 60%, I guess 20%. That's actually a 3-position knob, not a slider. Just kind of look like a slider, but it's not. You can see that what the bottom of the board looks like. Gonna go ahead and take this small Phillips screw out of this board as well. We can just remove this whole assembly. Just give it a good look over. So right off, nothing real obvious with the board. I don't really see a true fuse. The traces may be meant to be a fuse protection there and blow away, but everything's intact. This that almost looks like a fuse from a distance is actually probably our feedback current feedback resistor back to the microcontroller, and it's right there at the transistor output, so that makes sense. But if you watch my YouTube channel, you know that I have quite a few of these dual diode assemblies that's shorted, so this is a dual diode that is a common cathode, and you can see that little symbol on the bottom left there on diode check. This should be the same as pin 2. And it is. Ooh, that's not good. We're definitely showing a dead short. Whether that's going through something else or the diode is shorted. So let's take this diode off and then we'll check it out. So this is my dual diode here. That middle leg is always a booger to get hot enough. The pin 2 goes through the whole tab and through the heat sink. So I know you can't see it, but I make sure I got the diode itself off the heat sink to help some with the heat dissipation there. There we go, it's moving now. Got him. And this diode does not show shorted, so actually 0.164 voltage is actually a good shot key. Both ways, actually a really good diode. Very efficient, absolutely. Nothing wrong with the diode, it's just the way it's going through. So let's see, if we go across the pins. Oh yeah, all three pins are showing shorted, so the first check was the diode, been an easy fix too, but no dice, so let's keep going. It's even a clip around the round part of the trigger, clip underneath, around the round part of the trigger there, of course top and two on the side, another pushing clip right there at the top behind the trigger. There we go. And the cover is off. And there we go. T10 screws. Removed. Outer cover. The motor does spin free. Just a Phillips screwdriver here. Lock washer and a flat washer. Impeller comes off. Now we can remove the housing. So now we bring over our 20 volt supply, limited to 5 amps, so it could be a slow startup, even if it's okay. So I just wanted to get the motor out and make sure nothing was binding or that nothing looked burned up in the windings. And here we go with 20 volts. Our motor actually runs okay. So with the motor and a blower back together, motor tested, we'll look deeper into the speed control. We see here that in the actual trigger, we just have our contact. That's pretty neat. Our contact points come down and kind of with cam action and just make our circuit through, so that makes sense. Our little slide or wiper here, that's basically just a board mounted potentiometer there with our connectors coming back to the board. As our resistance changes, the slide goes back and forth to give our electronic feedback. And this is giving us some mechanical kind of contact closure to put it through. So
just simply putting that dual diode back on the board after we took it off and it was nothing wrong with it. And we know, looking at this board, that our red comes up and just jumpers up, and we saw our contact closure inside the contact. As we can see here, the red comes up and just goes back to blue. The actual negative is actually switched through the MOSFET, so the board's not doing that well. So it could even be the microcontroller on this board. But one way I'm going to check this, I do know that the contacts real conveniently take the positive from the battery terminal and goes through, and it comes back through the blue. So it's basically almost like a safety interrupt, where the electronic is supposed to do your speed control, as well as probably dropping the battery if the cell voltage gets too low to do your BMS part of the battery management and battery protection. But we can't get the MOSFET to do anything. So just for testing purposes, after ohming this out, we can actually jump. Just being careful here not to short across the 20 volts, but our black lead or our minus off the battery, bypassing the MOSFET up to go up to the blower. So now if we do the trigger, it'll just be our full 20 volts out to the motor. So there we go. So we don't have variable speed, but that actually is a way to run it. If this was just dead in the water, I would just disconnect some of the stuff so nothing will be back feeding through the diode or anything. So now, after testing the motor and the speed control contacts, and we know it's just the board it isn't putting out, I just want to bring my meter over on volts DC. And we see here that we have a controller bus. We have a reset, a VSS, a VDD, and a swim. So I was looking for 5 volts there. Maybe I'm not getting a good connection. I'm pushing pretty hard. And if you can see that, I'm getting 0 volts. We don't have a 5 volt, which I believe is a 5 volt regulated bus there for the microcontroller. So let's look into that. I do see something. I didn't notice this because the red wire happens to line right up on it.
But I was looking around where the red wire would come in, but actually right there, it looks like that says ZD3 like Zener diode. And that Zener diode is cooked there. I don't know what value of ZD3 is. It has definitely let the magic smoke out of it. Well, instead of keeping this video going much longer, I can't find what value that Zener diode should be. So that Zener is burnt up and I actually don't get any voltage across it or to it. So it means there's some other issues going on as well with this board. It could even be with the microcontroller, but I hadn't got that far. So since these batteries don't have the built-in protection, they're using this board to monitor with, and it looks like some of that circuitry that lets the bus voltage for the CPU is just not coming up. So to keep this video from going much further, I just thought, even though it's not the best case scenario, instead of junking this or just keeping it just merely for parts, we could still make it functional. We could just use the battery to go through the contacts and fully operate the blower, or at full 18 or 20 volts rather. So we got a full 20 volt pack potential across the blower, which is probably how we're going to run it most of the time anyway, is wide open, right? The drawback to this, and the reason it wouldn't be recommended for everybody, is you really got to monitor your pack, either looking at it yourself or just, you know, you realize when a tone changes and it starts getting really weak, you know that your battery's past due to be pulled out and charged, right? So just don't let your battery get pulled down too low, because that's what this does, is protects your battery from getting too low. So, and it also monitors the battery temperature too, so just be mindful of that. But let's see if we can go ahead and get this thing at least operational without digging into it for hours longer, because I've looked at it off camera about an hour, just going to make a long video. So it's time to probably cut the ties with that and save time. I'm going to cut this red from the battery pack because it joins on the board here. And I'm also going to cut the black that comes off the pack. We're no longer going to need the blue and the green for this test. We can simply unplug this. We'll cut the blue and the black here. So I'm just going to bypass the control board. I'm just going to strip these wires and we'll be right back. So we are not going to use this blue wire. We can solder these wires or whatever. This is just for testing. I may even put it together like this and see how it works. So actually our red and black just go together. We don't need the blue for the feedback, and we don't need, of course, the potentiometer for anything. We're just going to go across the contacts that they neatly built into this speed control. We won't have our nice speed control anymore, and hopefully that'll all line up. But anyway, just for testing here. Cool. All right. Let's see if we can put this back together. We'll put that there for looks. One thing kind of interesting, I didn't even realize when I was working on this that this tab was broken off, if you can see that. This tab for your forward reverse, or in this case it would be like the blow or the vacuum. I had put this back together and I took it back out to look at that, because it actually there was no way for this switch to work it, so that's kind of different. So that just locks it in run mode for you. Sounds good, but it don't do one thing. Still locks you back. Let's shoot the screws in it. Just T10 Torx. Looks like you could also do a flat on these as well if you wanted to. Non-security so far. So if you like this look inside this little DeWalt 20 volt max blower today, please like, share, subscribe, and thanks for watching.